The purpose of me doing this particular session is to show you the equivalence of x, the array operator, as well as star y when I am passing parameters to an array. Because I have written all the array problems using a combination of functions and pointers, because that is the only correct and right way to write array problems, or in fact any problems in C, you must use functions and pointers, because that is the basic expectation in industry when you go to work. Because once you use functions and pointers, it shows the person who is talking to you or interviewing to you that your fundamental concepts of C programming are clear. If you write everything in the main program, it really reflects that you have not learned C completely. So let's first take a look at what we're trying to do in this particular problem. I have declared an array A of 5 numbers, but I have given only 3 values, 99, 88 and 77. The rest of the 2 locations are going to be filled with 0 and 0. Int array B of 5 locations with these 3 numbers, the remaining 2 locations are going to be filled with 0s and 0s. Now if you see, I have declared a prototype of a function called as show, which has int and it says x as a single dimensional array and it says int star y. What I am going to try to show you here is whether you declare an array parameter as x array operator or star y, what you can do with this, you can do the same thing with y. So what is happening is a, address of a is going to x, address of b is going to y. So in this show function, what I am doing is I have declared the first parameter which is going to refer to A as x of array operator and B as star y. The reason they are both the same is x refers to the address of the 0th location of the array A. Y refers to the 0th location of array B. So whatever you can do using x, you should be able to comfortably do using y also. So if I have to print the content of array A, okay, I'm showing you in two different ways how you can print the content of array A. Starting from I is 0 to I less than 3, if I say x plus I, it is referring to A of 0. It is referring to A of 0, which is address 1000. So at the 1000th address, what is the value? It is going to print 99. Now I told you in the previous program, x of I is internally converted to star x plus I. So these both are the same. So using this for loop, I am going to print 99, 88 and 77. Okay. So you will see printing of x of I using two methods. Now since I told you this way of using an array parameter and this are the same, that means using something like this, I should be able to print array B also. Then only I can say both the things mean the one and same. So here what I am doing here is, here if you see, using Y, just as I used X here, I am able to print the content of array B. It will print 11, 22 and 33. And instead of saying star Y plus I, if I say Y of I also, it is going to print 11, 22 and 33. The moral of the story here, Y of array operator I is the same as star y plus I. This fellow is internally converted into this. Alright. So when I am passing parameters in the subsequent programs on arrays using functions, you will see that sometimes I will declare something like this. Majority of the times I will declare something like pointer to an array. So what I can do with a pointer to an array, I can do with a normal array type of a declaration also. The only difference between this and this is, this x will always refer to the address of A. I cannot change the address of this x because it is referring to a fixed address A. I am indicating that it's an array. Whereas this is a pointer type of a variable. Y is containing the address of B, but I can also give Y the address of array x if need be.